Hello guys, welcome to Rusty Science. This is not a fishy title. Please watch till end of the video to understand how leap year can have 367 days. Okay, let's jump into the topic. To understand a year, it's very essential to know what is a day. Okay, obviously you may know because all our textbooks says in our childhood says that it's a time taken for Earth to take complete 360 degree rotation. Right? Is it true? That's where the problem starts. When you say complete 360 degree rotation, you may need to answer the question with respect to what? Because Earth can play some sort of a dirty trick and it can say that, hey, I have completed the 360 degree rotation. So if you just, I want to give you some one of the metaphoric answer for this. So while if you are driving it in a car in a highway or something, the objects very closer to you will move faster. But an object too far from you may not move that much faster. It'll be too slow and it's very difficult to distinguish it. That's the principle we can follow. So we can take a distant star, far, far away star as a reference point in order to find out whether Earth has taken a 360 degree rotation. You may ask how it can help. Okay, this is how we can find out. Whenever the distant star faces just above your head, that you can take it as a reference time. And whenever the next time the same star comes above your head, then you can say Earth has actually taken 360 degree rotation. So we can consider that as one day. That's also our problem, right? No. Whenever Earth actually takes with respect to a distant star 360 degree rotation, that is called sidereal day. But sidereal day will not have 24 hours, it will have slightly lesser than 24 hours. We can say it as 23.9 hours. But what we thought is a day will have 24 hours. How did we come to that conclusion? Our important events like day, night, or seasons, all those things are not depends upon the distant star, but very close to us, sun. Okay? So we should consult with sun in order to find out whether it's a day or it's not a day. But here is the problem. Distant star and Earth has a difference because we are not revolving around distant star, but we are revolving around sun. Take an example. If we see from above, North Pole's above, Earth will be spinning counterclockwise. And in the same way, Earth will take a circle around sun in counterclockwise direction. Thus comes the problem. What happened? When the Earth started spinning in counterclockwise direction, in the meantime, Earth will move towards counterclockwise direction. So in that case, once 360 degree rotation is done, it with respect to the distant star, one day is done, but still it may require some extra turn in order to face towards our sun. We will only consider when the particular reference star come above your head. Only sun will come above your head once the little movement, we can consider as a theta, is added. In that case, if you see, that 23.9 hours just taken to one 360 degree rotation, but this extra theta is taken just to reposition ourselves to the sun. Okay, let's take this example. This is gonna serve us our space-time, and there is far, far away distant star exists in this direction. This will serve as the Earth. This sharp edge is going to track as Earth's movement. Okay, with respect to the distant star, if I have a complete 360 degree rotation, then I would consider that as one day, right? Whether it happens here or in this place, still we are going to say that as one day. Okay, now we are going to add one more variable, which is sun. Okay, listen carefully. Now the sharp edge is pointing to sun as well as the distant star. Consider if not only the Earth is moving in counterclockwise direction, it's going to move in counterclockwise direction. In this case, the next day, maybe Earth will be somewhere here, right? Our 360 degree rotation is over because 360 degree rotation, we always track with the distant star. Still, it's pointing to the distant star. That means the 360 degree rotation is over, but we will not consider this as one day because sun is here. It's not over our head. In that case, we may need to spin extra in order to make ourselves a day for us. This extra rotation, okay, This is what I mentioned as theta. Okay, this theta will be added every day. Okay, if you just move it the next day, it's gonna be here, but we need extra theta in order to point ourselves to the sun. The second phenomenon, what we can see it, assume that Earth is not at all gonna spin, okay, only it's gonna come around the sun. In that case, it's gonna be this point here, just always going to point sun wherever it goes. In that case, have a look at the pointer now. Okay, still this Earth is pointing to sun, but with respect to the distance star, already we are drifted by 90 degree. In some days it will be just keep moving till this pointy edge is moving to pointing towards sun. That means there is no rotation, but with respect to the distance star, already 180 degree has crossed. In the same way, if we just keep moves 270 and 360 degree, with respect to sun, there is not even a single day or single rotation being taken place, but with respect to the distance star, we already crossed 1360 degree. That means one extra day is already being counted. Okay, this one day, how it came, just we align ourselves to position to sun, it took this extra rotation.
366 days for leap year, right? So you can find that there is one extra 360 degree rotation be taken with respect to the distant star, not with respect to sun. This extra 360 degree rotation just to reposition itself to sun. Okay, so when I say 367 days for leap year, I did not mean that it's with respect to sun, which is called solar day. I meant with respect to the distant star, which is called sidereal day. So I want to clarify that we do have 367 days for every leap year, but not solar days, it's sidereal days. So hope you understand what is a sidereal day and what is a solar day. If you did not understand, we have our blog post. I completely written everything with pictorial explanation. Just see the link in the description below and click it, and you can find out all the information. Thank you.